Okay, hello?
Yes, I.
Okay, yes, it's recording now. Okay. So, yeah. Okay, thank you.
All right. Yes, I. This could be good medicine. St. Georgia.
Baruch one.
Hello? Greeting.
Greeting.
Oh. Yeah, greetings. Shalom to now.
Yes, shalom, shalom. This is Ross Georges.
This is Baruchu one I'm recording. Your soldier from I'm down in San Antonio, Texas right now, so this is I and I's first report.
Yes, I.
And who it was Ross Wendim Georges and who?
Yes, sister.
Salanta, this is Alonzo.
Alonzo, yes, I. Were you able to get in touch with Wendin Tobia?
Not necessarily, but there's, I was able to contact at least three other brothers. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to make it, but.
All right, bless it. Well, everyone like to just introduce themselves. It was like a lot of families were coming in, so.
Yes, I just come on the line, so I introduce, you know, I Ross Georges, so blessed be, yeah?
Yes, I could you repeat that? Georges?
Georges, yeah. I believe that's the Ethiopic translation for Greg, which is I birthright name, you know?
Yes, I perfect. Just want to get it right.
Yes,
yes, okay. Just thanks.
Oh, wait, you're on mute. I'm so sorry. I can't look over here. Sorry. Pardon.
I'm pretty sure. Y'all heard I and I's name, right?
Yes, I had a mute. Sorry, Brendan.
Did you guys get to hear the I's name?
No. I'm sorry, brother, to repeat.
You can call me Baruchu One.
Baruchu one. Yes, I.
Brethren, I
love her. Yes,
yeah, you know
I. Oh,
okay.
Yes.
I
just saw all your notebooks.
Oh.
Yeah,
hey, thanks.
Just to prove it. You're like, just in case.
Yeah, I had the notebooks and stuff. That's probably, you talking about, is that the YouTube thing you're talking about?
Yes, this is Emmanuel from Whom Marketing Cause.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, greetings.
Everybody, please introduce yourself.
Give thanks.
Yes, thanks.
I believe Sister in Salam. Can everyone just big up where they're coming from and maybe their skill? Like an art, you know, kind of like their skills, love, or passion. So
I personally do music.
And who's speaking?
That's Baruchu One.
Brother Baruchu One.
Baruchu One.
Okay.
Yeah, I do music and some writing and stuff like that, and just ghost writing.
Where do I hail from?
And what state you from? Where you hailing from?
I'm in Texas. Yeah,
oh,
I'm in Texas. I'm down here in San Antonio, actually, right now.
Yes,
okay.
Good guys. So, that's Georges, and, you know, I work in the land mass of Ethiopia, and, you know, I'm just really looking to communicate as I speak the language of the people, you know, the black population that is. So, you know, I feel it's an honor to, you know, take what goes on here and just kind of recreate it, you know, recreate it. For
right.
People. Yeah, Baruch Wendell. Baruch, bless, brother.
So Georges is really interested in, like, translation in Haiti, and he's doing a production studio over there, too. So media literacy, basically, center. That's what you
really
work in translating.
Okay, you said translating, and you said Arcadian. You said
In IT, in Haiti? Ethiopia.
I'm sorry. Okay. Mm-hmm. He's always, like the translation from like the, you know, Amarinya.
Amharic into what the,
Well,
the
translation's actually
trio?
For the lecture. It's more important than the lecture translations. The
lecture,
the messages. Lecture translations.
Yes,
the messages.
Okay, basically the script, like more the scriptural, basically, right? The scriptural translation.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
the,
I have. And Georgis, Georgis.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I just, you know, yeah. the stolen scrolls, you know, on our part, are in one sense just coming to recover, just coming to repossess our stolen scrolls, but. You know,
right.
by the same token, you know, I want to give it to the people firsthand so they don't miss out in their language. So I travel, and my presence is literally there. So even though
wow.
in California right now, but, you know, I'm time traveling, and soon I should be. So keeping contact and staying up to date is priority. So that's why I'm on the line, you know.
Yeah. So,
anyone else has some great gifts of art?
Yeah.
And anyone else wants? Because I know there's some artists. I know Brother Mandela, you being shy out there.
Yeah. I was being quiet.
I will pull
Brother
you out of the circle.
Brother Mandela out in downtown Los Angeles, California. I play djembe. It was coming from Yoruba, traditional Yoruba rhythm. So nothing, you know, just on the traditional part.
Yes,
so,
That's good. That's Baruch, blessings to you, Wendell. You know, blessings, brother.
Thank you.
You know, stay true. You know, it's good to hear y'all voices on the phone, to hear some other true Rastafari.
Yes,
because I know how you feel out there, because, you know, I feel alone.
Let's go ahead and continue around the circle, you know. Okay.
Yes,
everybody.
Brother Mandela is in charge of the communication. Yes, I. Thank you, Bridget.
Yes, I. Moving forward, this is Bridget Eliyahu. I am in control of the fruits and the roots.
Yes, I.
Healing
of the nations.
I, the healing of the nations. One nation for
yes,
a time. So.
Big up, Eliyahu. Big up, Eliyahu.
Yes, I. He is the herbal, nutritional fruit roots and fruits.
Wow.
Brethren.
Oh, that's good.
Anyone have any type of ailment in the I can put together a herb, a roots compound just for the eye. So, see.
Wow.
Yes, I.
And where is Brother Ross Eliyahu root from?
Well, right now, I is in Northern California, so.
Okay.
Okay, I will.
Yes, I.
Where's Brother Alfonso?
I'm here.
Yes, I. You don't want me to call you Alfonso this week. Yes, I was messing it up last strong. Like, I needed some minerals.
You were learning.
Excuse me, Alonzo?
Yes.
Alonzo, Brother Alonzo, yes. We're going to have, hopefully, Brother Wendim Yadin will be on the line soon. But, you know, we're not going to do the, I forgot to tell you, you know, there's styles of going into detail about the UCC, so we're not going to worry about that now. We got to worry about the Torah coming into the Sabbath day, because, you know, this is the Eve right now. So coming into I want to say one of the sisters was going to read a psalm. Is that?
I do want to say, Brother Alonzo, big up for his artwork. So, and I just wanted to, I wanted to have everyone meet each other, because as you can see, we're all kind of art, theater, media, education, production. And so, believe that's our strong point.
Okay. Who hasn't gone?
I haven't. Sister Salam. Greetings, blessings. Shabbat Shalom. I'm calling from the Virgin Islands. And my interests are education and writing language. Also, I make my own some of my own like oils and incense and different things like that. I sew and make my own clothes. So those are some of my interests.
Salam Sanaa, Sanaa Yastuli.
Yes, sir.
Salam Tas.
Ine Wendim Topia. Name.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear that.
There's a Ine Wendim Topia. Name. Wendim
Topia. All right, there you go. Remember we were talking about it earlier. That somebody was asking about it.
Kind of busy, but you know, I called in to link up with the item. So, Senbet Salam, Shabbat Shalom, Rastafari.
Hey,
yes, I. Yes, I. This connection is so powerful, it's reverberating through the lines. Yes, I.
It is.
A little echo, yeah.
To the celestials, praise Jah, because we're making movements right now.
Oh.
Yes, it's an honor and a pleasure.
Yes, I'm Brendan Soviet. Thank you so much for being on the line, Miss Donna. Shalom.
Rastovia.
Shabbat Shalom. And I know a number of us would like to talk to you about other things post-Sabbath, MCA included.
Oh, true.
Okay.
Yes, I said, Sister Salam, we are waiting. Thank you. For your reading, your psalms reading.
Oh, yes. I had a question, Rastovia. Where, Rastovia, where does he dwell?
Where am I?
Yes.
I'm in Miami right now.
Oh, Miami. Okay.
Oh.
I think Ross J is in Florida as well.
Yes, Ross
who?
J. Also
yeah, Ross J. Yeah.
Probably from. I'm so. I also go by the MC name of Sulfuric. Right now I'm residing in Brandon, Florida, which is like right next to Tampa. I'm also a massage therapist looking to incorporate natural medicine, chakra healing, stuff of that matter.
Oh.
Beautiful.
Shabbat Shalom.
Sounds like we're all equipped.
Indeed.
Yes, that's it. God bless.
Yes, hi. So would someone like to open up a prayer before Sister Salam opens up the reading? Would anybody like to volunteer?
If y'all would like, if y'all would like, you know, I could do our Father prayer and then Amarinya.
Yes, I.
Yes, I.
Oh, you ready?
Good night.
Abba Tachin Hoy, Besamai Yimishinor, Simi Yikudesh Mingishi Timita, Bequadi Besamai Indihonich, Indehu Bemidir Tehun, Ye Ilet Injuratin in Tikunzare, Bedelachin in Yurkur Belin, Inaa Yibidelun in Yurkur in the Menil. With the first Knam Atagiban Kekifu Adenin Inji, Mingish Yanti Nasina Ke Hailam Misganam Lezule Alemu. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh.
And Baruch saw the eye. You know, that's my prayer right there.
Okay, Sister Salam?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, I.
Bless you.
I thought that.
Miss Ghana.
Miss Ghana. I thought we could start with reading the Lion of Judah Society Evening Psalm 93 for the Sabbath. Yes, I. The Lord reigneth. He is clothed with majesty. The Lord is clothed with strength, wherewith he hath girded himself. The world also is established, that it cannot be moved. Thy throne is established of old. Thou art from everlasting. The floods have lifted up, O Lord. The floods have lifted up their voice. The floods lift up their waves. The Lord on high is mightier than the noise of many waters. Yea, than the mighty waves of the sea. Thy testimonies are very sure. Holiness becometh thine house, O Lord, for ever and ever. Rastafari. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, give thanks and praises to the Most High.
Yes, I.
I will.
Who liveth and reigneth forever.
Yes, yes. I will.
Talasia.
Mandela, you said we should go over the Torah readings?
Okay. I would just go on, you know, right now it's just Eve, so right now I would...
just one moment.
Like coming into the day, you observe, you know, to observe it on the day. Who's on the line?
Salam, it's Wendim. Kobe, I got cut off.
Oh, okay. Yes, this is Brother Mandela. I was going to go ahead and do an intro into the portion, you know, for this. No. You know, anybody do, if they have anything prepared, can go ahead and
I just got word from Wendim Yadon. Yeah, Wendim Yadon is about to call in.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Indeed.
Now
that's fine.
I'm probably just a little quiet, but I'm here. Oh, yeah.
Anyone is wanting to do the reading, that'd be wonderful. Or a psalms, or...
Yeah, can that in hear me?
Yes, sir. Hello?
Yes, sir. Oh. Yeah, I'm just hearing a lot of, like, static and a lot of voice coming from different areas. I don't know how it is.
Okay, so how about we just take it easy, you know, we got to take it easy now, because there's a lot going on.
Does everyone want to try to hang up and call again?
It's like an echo. We could do that.
everyone on speaker?
Somebody who's an echo something keep going.
Here's the problem with technology. Okay. I think the feedback, is that better?
Maybe too many people on speaker. Perhaps people.
Now it sounds good.
Yes, I.
Yes, I and I turn.
Thank you, Brother Eliyahu.
Yeah, I don't hear it.
Oh. You all get turn the speaker off, for real.
Okay.
Yes, loud and clear.
Yeah, that's better.
Good job. Is it still one branch?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it's done.
Yes, sir. I just got confirmation from Wendim Yadon. Said he's trying to call in right now. Indeed.
Oh, wow.
Yes, this port week tour question is the 49th, correct?
42. No,
I is back. Wendim Hazel and Brandy Hazel will be calling in also from California in a few.
Okay.
I will.
Brother Paul, aren't
we in Rastafari Shabbatical reading 50? We did 49 last Sabbath.
We did 49 last Shabbat.
I mean,
okay.
it's 49:50. There's no discrepancy, you see.
Yeah,
I believe we covered the Wata Gezi last Shabbat, and we're going into the Geba Gezi, or Kitavo.
Okay. So the 49th one is Deuteronomy 21:10, 25:19, and the 50th is Deuteronomy 26:1 to 29:8.
I will.
Yeah. And
yes.
Deuteronomy 10.
No, on the 21:10.
Okay, 21:10, 21:10. Deuteronomy 26 and verse 1 to 29 and verse 8.
Yeah, I'm going
to yes, sir.
Okay, do the item.
What is the any of the eyes know? What is the basically? What is the English for the
Berwitha
Gizeh?
Oh, you're on mute, Pop.
Okay, who?
The 26:01.
Which yeah, 26:1.
26:1. Everybody ready? I start to read.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. 2601 to where?
Oh, it'd be the first.
29-8.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, give
thanks. Yep. Okay. Yes.
When I and I come into the land which the Lord, I and I Elohim, is giving I to occupy as I and I patrimony and settle in it, I and I shall take the first fruits of all the produce of the soil which I and I gather in from the land which the Almighty Jah is giving I and I, and put That's them in a basket. Then I and I shall go to the place which the Almighty Father Jah will choose as a dwelling for his name, and come to the priest, whoever he shall be in those days. I and I shall say to him, I declare this day to the Almighty Jah that I have entered the land which the Almighty swore to our forefathers to give to I and I. The priest shall take the basket from I and I hand, and set it down before the altar of the Almighty Jah, Rastafari. All right. Then I and I shall solemnly recite before the Almighty Jah, I, Father, was a homeless Aramean who went down Kemet with a small company and lived there until they became a great, powerful, and numerous nation. But the Egyptian ill-treated us, humiliated I and I, and imposed cruel slavery upon I and I. Then I and I cried to the Almighty Jah of I and I fathers for help, and him listened to I and I and saw our humiliation, I and I hardship and distress. And so the Almighty brought I and I out of Kemet with a strong hand and outstretched arm, with terrifying deeds and with signs and portents. He brought I and I to this place and give us this land, land flowing with milk and honey, Rastafari.
Oh, whoa. Oh,
yes, sir. And now I have brought the first fruits of the soil, which thou, O Jah, hast given I. You shall then set the basket before the Almighty Jah, I and I Elohim, and bow down in worship before him. I and I shall all rejoice, I and I, and the Levites, and the aliens living amongst I.
Yeah, Rastafari.
Yes, I. For all the good things the Almighty Jah has given to I and I and to I family. When I and I have finished taking a tithe of I and I produce in the third year, the tithe year, I and I shall give it to the Levite and to the alien, the orphan, and the widows. They shall eat it in I and I settlements and be well fed. Then I and I shall declare before the Almighty Jah, I have rid I house of the tithe that was holy to thee and given it to the Levites, to the alien, the orphan, and the widows, according to all the commandment which thou didst lay upon I and I. I have not been broken or forgotten any of the commandments. I have not eaten any of the tithe while in the morning, nor have I rid myself of it for unclean purposes, nor offered any of it to the dead. I have obeyed the Almighty Jah, Rastafari. I have done all that thou didst command I and I. Look down from heaven, thy holy dwelling place, and bless thy people, Israel, and the ground which thou hast given to I and I, as thou didst swear to I and I forefather, a land flowing with milk and honey. This day, the Almighty Jah commands I and I to keep these statutes and law. Be careful to obey them with all of I and I heart and all of I and I soul. I and I have recognized the Almighty Father this day as I and I Elohim. I and I are to conform to him ways, to keep his statutes, his commandment, and him laws, and to obey him. The Almighty Jah has recognized I and I this day as his special possession, as he promised I and I, and to keep him commandments. He will raise I and I high above all the nations, which he has made, to bring him praise and fame and glory, to be a people holy to the Almighty Jah, according to his promise. Yes, I.
Okay, I will.
Amen,
yes,
amen.
Amen.
Yes,
I.
Amen, amen.
Yeah, so what the brother just read is 9:26-19, which is actually, that's like, he read, now in like the Hebrew or the Judaic Aliyah, the reading, now that's the three, he just read three portions of the reading.
Mm.
So, yeah, so, you know, if we were like in a place on a Saturday to read, that would be three people would have been split up, I think, by the three, you know, three different people would have been called up, you know, to read that
mm-hmm.
right there. You know, as you know, I'm reading this off the wiki, you know, the wiki.
Oh,
yeah, that splits it up, you know, the first reading.
The Kitavov, right?
Yeah, yeah. If anybody, you know, can look at it, you know, just take a look at it, you know, see, because that's how it's structured, and that, you know, and that's, you know, part of the Judaic thing, you know, which is, you know, that
the way
that
order,
that,
which is
where,
right?
That even
that's fine. So we'll be getting it in the order, and that's definitely what we're trying to get back in the Levitical, get back to the old school. But would anybody like to build on that? Reason on that? On that scripture?
That's fine. I mean, that whole, the whole Judaic study, that, you know, the Ihud way, like that order, that sounds right, you know?
Yeah, because, you know, even though, because, you know, it was a wild, you know, the wild tree grafted in, so they did, you got to think now about the old,
right.
You know, black Jews, you know, because, you know, like, was it Rabbi Matthews, you know, from Harlem, you know, like, even though they're, you know, European, they still keep up. Even though they have, like, you know, rabbinical stuff and things like that, they still kept part of the old ways that, you know, we can learn from, you know. So that's the whole thing, you know.
Yeah, I look at it too. I go over, you know, a lot of the you know, the wiki and just, you know, different different details wherever it may come from, and I go over them and just go look through the details, and, you know, even through, like, some of it is lies, I still, you know, I look, be able to look over it and, you know, not let that bother I and I, like, you know, I used to back before. Now I and I is, you know, better acquainted with how to study it and through the details. To see through the lies. There's still a lot of lies that'll be, just checked, you know, when the eye is speaking to the apophis, you know. But, you know, other than that, you know, yeah, the eye don't, you know, I just try to hold it.
Well, reference to the scriptures, though, I read a scripture, I feel like it should be something I said upon a scriptural tip, because this is a reading and feeding, and I don't hear anyone reasoning upon the scripture. And time has passed, I feel like ones and ones have not even thought about it, maybe not heard it, worried about the way it was delivered.
You know, it's funny, because the eye was, that's interesting, I'm glad you said eye, and, you know, Baruch, I appreciate that, because, you know, the eyes meet that too. Yeah, that's interesting you're saying that, because just probably yesterday, I think I was going over the verse in 26:2 in Deuteronomy 26:2, it says that thou shalt take of the first of all the fruit of the earth, which thou shalt bring of thy land, that the Yahweh Elohim, Yahweh Had, Baruch Hu Egeziah, shall give thee, and shall put it in the basket, and shall go to the place which the Yahweh, thy Yahweh, shall choose to place his name there. And it just reminded me about, you know, Getamawi and the whole Dawidic, the covenant, the kingdom being planted in that place, you know, as the representation of Ethiopia. And it kind of reminded me, but the whole thing about it now is like when I study these verses now, I go over them in the English first, but then I go over them in the Hebrew, and then I really go over them detailed and, you know, in the Amharic, you know, as best as I can. So now it's like, even at the same time when I hear these verses, I listen to them and I read them, but then I get the deeper details out the Amharic, because what the eye is starting to find out about these verses and the Amharic is that the words in the Amharic are metonymical words, which, like, they break down for a family of meanings in one word. You know, like lock and, you know what I mean?
Okay, yeah. So you're coming from Hebrew, Hebraic.
I studied both of them, you know. I studied
okay,
the,
but you learned
the Hebrew,
first
like,
22.
Yeah,
okay,
basically.
Moving on, are we talking in scriptures? Are we building? Is this a building?
Is there
another translation also, maybe a part that you'd like to read, Brother Buruku, that, you know, you were building on
okay,
that family?
Okay, so,
Please. Yes, okay.
So we had left off after the third reading, Deuteronomy 26, 16, and 19. We continue with 27. We can go ahead with 27
and 1. That's the fourth reading.
And
that's the fourth Aliyah, 1 through 10.
Yes, I
can read
that,
1 through 10.
I
is going to read chapter 7, verse 1 through 10. And Musa, with the elders of Israel, commanded the people, saying, Keep all the commandments which I command to I this day, and it shall be on the day that I and I shall pass over Jordan unto the land which Yahweh Eloheinu, thy Elohim, give it to thee, that thou shalt set thee up great stones and plaster them with the plaster, and thou shalt write upon them all the words of this law, when I and I art passed over, that I and I may go into the land which Kedemawe Halisilasi Elohim gave it to thee, a land that floweth with milk and honey. And Yahweh Elohim of thy fathers hath promised thee. Therefore it shall be written, when I and I be gone over Jordan, that I and I shall set up these stones, which I and I command to the eye this day in Mount Ebal, and thou shalt plaster them with plaster. And there shall thou build an altar. Shalom Tana, Tana Yistilim.
Shalom Rastafari, Wendim Och, Hitoch. Greetings, brother.
Shalom Wendim Yadon.
Shalom.
Yes, the I was just going over the fourth reading of our 50th Rastafari Shabbatical reading in Deuteronomy 27, verse 1 through 10. Let the I just finish up these last five verses. I and I shall build, this is verse 6, I and I shall build an altar of Yahweh Elohim, who of whole stones, and I and I shall offer burnt offerings there unto Yahweh Eloheinu. And thou shalt offer peace offerings, and thou eat there, and rejoice before Yahweh. and thou shalt write upon the stones all the words of thy law very plainly. And Moshe, the priest, and Moshe and the priests of the Levites spake unto Israel, saying, take heed and hearken, O Israel, Shema Israel. This day thou art become the people of Kedamawi Haile Selassie, thy God, thy Elohim.
Amen.
Thou therefore obey the voice of Elohim, Yahweh Eloheinu, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, thy Father, and do his commandments, the statutes, which I command thee this day. Oh, so that's the fourth reading.
Okay, I think that I had on the, it was going from the wiki, right? From the Wikipedia page?
I will.
But I know there's two different kind of forms of it. One that breaks it down into the reading, and then one that kind of gives a summary or overview. But give thanks, greetings, Mr. Abisa. Let's see. Give me one moment right here. Yeah. So I think on the, did you go through the part where which one? You're in Kitavo, right?
Oh.
Yes, yes.
Kitavo. All right, Begebahim Gizeh. Begebahim Gizeh. And the first part you was going over Deuteronomy 26:1 to Deuteronomy 29:8. Now there's one that has I saw this difference in the ones that we compiled didn't break down the readings directly in it, but what it did was give an overview of the summary of parts. And I don't know whether they had updated or changed the Wikipedia, you know, or not, because we had downloaded it maybe from over a year ago, about a year, roughly within the year. So there's a part where it gives a summary. How can I show this to the item? Like,
no.
Could be another brother, sister coming in.
Greetings, Salam.
Shalom.
Shalom. Oh, so.
Sorry,
all right,
I had dropped off.
So which version, just to clarify, which version of, you have the one with the readings, right? You look up Kitavo with the readings. Is it the Kitavo, the Parsha one, or is it another one? Because this is for the Aliyah, the going up, trying to see if we can get on
okay.
the same page.
Okay, excuse me, Brother Yada. This is Mandela, Brother Mandela. Now, I had...
Oh.
Yes, yes. Now, I had looked up, first of all, we went over, you know, that there's a difference, you know, 49 and 50 that they, now, which one, you know, is to be read. And then, you know, when we were reading 50, I had pulled up the wiki, and I had looked up the readings right here. You know, I just had looked up the first reading, second reading, and you know, I didn't pull it up until after one of the brethren, who was, you know, read the first three parts. I had looked up.
Yeah, no problem with that. I just wanted to state that this is kind of like some of the basic, kind of one-on-one getting familiar with it, the readings, in the Old Testament or first century sense, the readings would be like for each one going up to the Torah and would read, like in the synagogue or the mikvah sense. So like ones would be chosen for that honor of being a reader, you know, in the sense of
like from the Hebrew or for I and I from the Amharic. But right now, for us getting familiar with it, we're utilizing, you know, the English. So that's why those readings would be called like the Aliyah or the Aliyot in the Hebrew, like the Aliyah. Aliyah also means to modern Hebrew and Jewish people, whether black or white, in the modern sense, the Aliyah would be literally, it means like ascending or going up. So to go up to read from the bima, what's called the bima, or like where the table would be, say in a church or within the synagogue, where the Torah would be going up, because it was the idea of like going up to Jerusalem or going up to the temple, but in the private churchical sense, derived from the synagogue sense, since Yeshua and the other first Messiahian or Messiahites, they were Jews or Judaic. That's why Christ says, ye worship what ye know not, but we know what we worship for salvation is of the Jews or of Judah, the Ehud, right? So, because when you look in how the church, if you notice how the Kedase, the liturgy goes in the Ethiopian church, if you really pay attention to it, if you know how synagogue services go on, there is a, within the orthodoxy, you understand, especially the Eastern or the Oriental churches, it has the same sort of flavor. Like the Jews would say the Kaddish, or Kaddish, they say Kaddish. Bad pronunciation, but they say Kaddish. That would be the Kedase, what we call the Kedase. And the Kedase, of course, is from Mekades. Mekades would be the sanctuary or the holy place. And Kedase would be to something that it or he is holy in that sense. Kedase. I'm just breaking down the verbs so that ones get a little familiar. Now, there's a place in the wilderness experience which is known as Kadesh or Kadesh, where it was at the place called Kadesh. You might recall in the Torah portion readings that they went through this experience. Yeah, the Kadesh Barnea. Yeah, Kadesh Barnea. So why I'm trying to get the eye of them at least familiar with this, maybe take some notes of this, because as you start to, first of all, what does the word mean, right? And the Kadase would be the translated, they call it the liturgy, right? But to the Ethiopian Christians, we call it Kedase, and then it's the same in a sense with the Ethiopian Jews, and we're speaking about the Beit Israel before, and now they do it more after this particular order that we're going over as a basic kind of idea. So there's two different pages on the Wikipedia. There's one which we compiled into the five books. In fact, what we're going to try to do is put that up as a PDF, now that we have all five books complete, so that ones will be able to at least have it in a PDF form. I mean, you know, so that we'll be more or less on the same page. Now, the reading part is good in the sense of I and I gathered together, especially if we were physically gathered together, all in the same place, or if we were having, what they call it, the Kedase. You know, that means that one reader, you know, would come up after, like, the priest or after the main responsible individuals would read first. I say responsible because, in truth, the reading would not be so much just in English. You know what I'm saying? That the honor would really be come up to read in the Hebrew or to read in the Amharic, or in some communities to read in the Ge'ez, on that sort of level. But the summary version is what we printed, and that's why when I heard you mention, okay, this reading and that reading, I began to say, oh, that's right, they have two different, you know, they have two different types of pages up there, you know, for you know, the Jewish or Torah portion. So it gets a little bit in detail, if you over is what I'm trying to say, a little bit in detail. So there's one that has the readings that break it down into the equivalent number of readings, and there's another one that explains a summary. So what we've been teaching from is the summary,
Yehovah, so that we'll have a basic overall idea. Because we could go through the readings and hear, you know, through the readings, but if we get a summary of it, then each of us, as we have opportunity studying, you know, or reading over the rest of the Shabbat or even during the week, this would be like also the meditation for the week, Yehovah, saying, or for the other six or so days coming forward. You know what I'm saying? I mean, am I making myself clear or making it actually clear? And there's a difference. So what I have here is a summary, and I'm trying to look at the Wikipedia if I could find out what's the difference between the two. You know what I'm saying? Like you go to one page, you know they have like the disambiguation page. When you look up something, they say, do you mean such and such? Do you mean this or that? Like things that have similar names to it. You know what I mean? Like if you say look up Israel, or you might get also black or Hebrew. They might have black Hebrew, so they'll give you like a disambiguation page. If you click on that, then you actually go to another like subset of the particular subject matter, of the particular issue. So I had wanted us to really study from the overview. Now, as far as which reading for this week or this Shabbat, this Senbet, it would actually be the 50th portion, but then I was studying it, and perhaps with one Shabbat, you know, like if you look at the reading for the 51st, which is Nitzavim in the Hebrew, or Komat Chuchal, which means, right. and you all stand, is really the one that will be read right before Yom Kippur, I mean, right before Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah, how many of y'all saw the video where I tried to explain the Melkam Adis Ledet and the solar and the lunar, the Christian and the Jewish, or the Judeo and the Christian aspect, the mother and the father aspect?
I tried to study those videos in detail. I think I was watching that one about the where you broke down the years, but it was, I think it was right around that one is right around the leprosy one you did. So I kind of had mixed them up when I was writing it in my folder, but I do remember the one where you were on the solar and the lunar, the calculations in time with the leap year and how they thought it was a leap year here in the
right.
U.S., but it's really not.
Because last Ethiopian Addis Ahmed was actually the 12th, if you recall. It was the 12th of September. And it's interesting in a sense because when the revolution and all that also occurred, it also occurred, I think, on a leap year too in Ethiopia,
wow.
You know, which is a whole other matter right there. But yeah, in other words, our leap year in a sense already occurred, and they are having, you know, like right now, this is a new year we're already in a new year in Christ, right?
Yeah.
In the new covenant, having father, mother, brother, and sister. You know what I mean? And now we're about to honor the Judaic aspect, which is the so-called Rosh Hashanah. You know what I'm saying? Because these both belong to us. But how do they
right.
fit?
The Hebrew and the Amharic, right? The Hebrew
well,
and the Ethiopic.
I didn't hear the I clear. You
my
there?
Apologies. The Hebrew and the Ethiopic?
In other words,
yeah, that's how I've been trying to study it too.
Yeah, and how many of y'all saw the video? I think this is really this was almost like a revelation to me while I was recording it, and even before I recorded it. And it's interesting that that's when the hit came against the Ethiopian world net. I noticed whenever some new growth happens, at least in my life, or a new understanding or perception, I used to think that, like, when I was growing up, I would get a little sick, right? You know, like you get a cold or something like that. But it's always at some time when it's almost like you're growing. So it's almost like the Lord slows you down for a moment. Like you may think, even as people persecuting you or things are going on, but the Lord wants you just to be quiet for a moment, or he's trying to show you something. So it's like when this new revelation on a certain level came through for I and I. This was at the very same time as we got the strike against the Ethiopian World Net or the Ilnet account. And so we wasn't able to post that video. We was really excited to post the 49th Torah portion, Kia Tetzah, or in Amharic, Be'wetah